Hello students, in today's lecture of a design of an AC machine, we are moving further in the stator design, right? Today's topic is selection of the number of stator slots. What are the parameters that affect the selection? Okay, we are going to see that. The first parameter that affects the selection of the number of stator slots is tooth pulsation losses, second is leakage reactance, third is mechanical difficulties, fourth is cost, and the fifth one and the final one is the magnetizing current and the magnetizing current and core losses. So one by one we will be seeing how these parameters affect the number of stator slot selections, right? So first is the tooth pulsation losses. Now we know that on the inner periphery of the stator the slots are cut out, right? So what happens, the length of the air gap is different at various places. Suppose this is our stator and we are having this teeth cut out, okay? So what happens, and here is our rotor. Suppose what happens, the length of the air gap over here and length of the air gap over here is quite different, okay? So what happens here, the reluctance offered is also different. So when we use or when we are using an open slots, there will be a large variation in the length of the air gap and also in the variation in the reluctance in the air gap. So thus the slots are selected. How the slots are selected? To give the minimum variation in the air gap reluctance. We have to make sure that there is not very high variations in the reluctance at the air gap. So due to that, tooth pulsation losses and noise will also reduce. If this variation is very large, the reluctance variation is very large, then the tooth pulsation losses will be also very high, okay? And the noise, the operation of the machine will be also be noisy. This can be achieved by using the large number of narrow slots. That means if we use narrow slots and large number of narrow slots are used, then the air gap will be almost uniform, or we can say the variation in the reluctance or the length of the air gap will not be that much as compared to that of the open slots. So moving further, leakage reactance. Now if we are using large number of slots, okay, then in the large number of slots there will be large number of conductors placed inside that slots, and also the insulation provided to them will also increase. Thus the reluctance path, okay, the reluctance offered to the leakage flux will also be more. So the leakage reactance will reduce, okay? And if the leakage reactance is reduced, then the diameter of the sulcus diaphragm will increase and the overload capacity will also increase, okay? So leakage reactance, if we are using larger number of slots, more conductors, more insulator, more reluctance to the leakage flux, and hence the leakage flux will be reduced, okay? And due to that, overload capacity of the machine is improved. Now the mechanical difficulties. Now what happens when we use large number of stator slots? If we use large number of stator slots, then the slot pitch will be less, okay? And the tooth width, that is if we are cutting this slot over here, okay, like this, then this is known as our teeth. This is our teeth. So what happens if the tooth, this slot is very small, then the tooth width will be also very small, okay? It will result in a weak magnetic structure, and it will need laminations. Laminations will need mechanical support, which may cause obstruction in the ventilation circuit. What we have to remember is, if we are going for larger number of slots, then the slot pitch will be very less, that is this portion or this length will be very less. Due to that, tooth width is also very less and the magnetic structure is very very poor or weak, and the laminations will require mechanical support. And if we provide mechanical support, then there will be obstruction in the ventilation circuit, okay? Also, the reduced cross section of the teeth will have a large flux density. That means area is reduced, then the flux density will automatically increase. Magnetizing current and higher iron losses, these are the some of the disadvantages or the mechanical difficulties that we face when the large number of stator slots are considered, okay? Now when large number of slots, okay, we will require larger number of coils, also the conductors, and we will also be required to provide the insulations, right? It will increase the overall cost and its labor cost, okay? Now fifth point, magnetizing current and core losses. Large number of stator slots, what will happen? High flux density, as I already said, that due to less cross-sectional area, flux density will be on the higher side. The tooth section will require higher magnetizing current and increase the core losses. Now, magnetizing current increases, the power factor will also be impacted, and due to that, the performance of the machine will be less. So here I'll follow a few of the guidelines that we have to follow while selecting the stator slots. What are they? The number of the stator slots should be always an integral number. Okay, number of stator slots per pole per phase. Okay, it should be a number, it should not be in a decimal. Generally, for small medium size motor, slots per pole per phase lies between 3 to 5, and for narrow range 3 to 4. Okay, these are the ranges that are provided to you. Slot pitch or for the open slots lies between 15 to 25 mm, and if we use semi-enclosed slots, it may be less than 15 mm, right? The number of conductors per slots must be in the even number for double layer winding, that is, it is 4, 6, 8, it should be in an even number, right? So these were the criteria or the parameters which decide the number of stator slots. Now we move further, stator slot pitch. The stator slot pitch, first of all, it is denoted by YSS. Okay, this you have to remember. It is denoted by YSS, and it is given by gap surface. Gap surface is nothing but pi d upon total number of stator slots, that is denoted by SS. So we can say that the stator slot pitch YSS is given by pi d upon SS. Pi d is nothing but the gap area upon number of stator slots, right? So SS, we can find number of stator slots. If the stator slot pitch is given, we can easily find the number of stator slots. Now, total number of stator conductors, number of phases. So we are designing three phase induction motor, so it is three conductors per phase. Now, conductors per phase is given by 2 into TS. Okay, 2 into TS, because there are, in one coil there are two conductors. Okay, so 2TS, so we are getting total number of conductors, stator conductor, as 6TS. With this we have already seen ahead. Okay, now turns, TS is nothing but the turns per phase, that we have derived the formula yesterday itself. Now the conductor slots per slot, conductors per slot, what total number of conductors is 6TS, and our number of stator slots that we have already found out here is SS. So we will be getting the conductors slot, conductors per slot. Okay, now moving further, area of the stator slot, area of the stator slot, this also we have covered. The area, approximate area of the stator slot is given by the copper area per slot, that is the area that is occupied by our conductor, and the space factor, right? Now what is space factor? Space factor is nothing but a ratio of total copper cross sectional area upon the total area. Okay, the area occupied by the copper upon the total area of the core. Now copper area is given by, now ZSS is nothing but the ZSS is nothing but the conductors per slot, AS is the area, and space factor. Now the value of the space factor is taken between 0.25 to 0.4. high voltage machines have lower space factors due to large thickness of insulations. This is easily relatable, because we know that if the value of the voltage increases, we need to provide higher insulations, and higher insulations will occupy higher space. So the value of the space factor, and automatically if the insulation is taking more space, then the copper will be, the space occupied by the copper will reduce. Okay, so what happens? The space factor for the high voltage machine is on the lower side. Okay, now after obtaining the area of the slots, the dimension of the slot should be adjusted. The slot should not be too wide or too thin. This is easily relatable, as the slot should not be very thick. Slot size or the width should not be very small, neither it should be very thin. Okay, now the width of the slot should be adjusted based on the flux density, because the flux density in the teeth should be between 1.3 to 1.7 Weber per meter square, right? So these are for the area of the stator slots. Okay, now we will move further. Then the last second last part in the stator design is the length of the main turn. Okay, now the length of the main turn means the length of the main turn of the stator winding of for an induction motor is calculated using the following formula. Now it is given by length of the main turn is given by 2L plus 2.3 tau plus 0.24. now this is already a derived formula, right? In that, L is nothing but the length of the stator bore, which we have already seen in the main dimensions, that is L and D. L is nothing but the length of the stator bore and D is the diameter of the stator, where tau is the pole pitch, and we have already seen tau is given by pi D by P. Okay, so now length of the main turn, you are quite clear, it is given by the equation 2L plus 2.3 tau plus 0.24. okay, now stator winding resistance. Now you all might be aware with the formula R is equal to rho L by A. Okay, this is a very basic formula that we have learned in the basic subjects of elements of electrical engineering. It is a simple formula, R is equal to rho L by A, where rho is the resistivity of the material, L is the length of the wire, and A is the cross sectional area of the conductor. So here we are going to find the resistance, or the entire resistance of the stator winding. Now this RS is equal to rho LMTS, which is the length of the main turn, A is the area of the stator, and now this entire thing, or this formula up to this part, is for one turn, and total number of turns per phase is TS. So if we want to find the total resistance, we have to multiply this resistance with the total number of turns. So we will be getting the total stator resistance. Okay, total stator resistance. So here the notations, as I have already said, rho is the resistivity of the conductor material, and mostly we are using the conductor material as copper, and for copper the specific or the resistivity is given 0.021 ohm meter per mm square. Well, LMT is length of the main turn, A is the area of the cross section of the conductors of the stator, and TS is the number of stator turns, right? So here the design part of the stator, we will move further. Now the design of the slots is completed. Now we will be going for the stator teeth design. Okay, now in a stator teeth, maximum permissible flux density is about 1.7 Weber per meter square. Now therefore the minimum tooth width, now you here you can see, suppose okay, so these are our slots. Okay, this is our slot, and the above portion is our teeth. These are the teeth. Now we are going for the design of the teeth. Now the minimum tooth width, this we are talking about, this portion, what should be the width of our teeth. Okay, now the minimum width is given by the formula phi m upon 1.7 ss upon p into li. Now phi m is nothing but the flux per pole, then ss is the total number of slots that we already derived, p is the total number of poles, and li is the length, iron length of the teeth, that is given by here li. This is li. Okay, so you are clear with all the notations in this equation. The minimum tooth width is given by WTS is given by phi m, which is the flux per pole, SS is the number of slots, P is the number of poles, and LI is nothing but the iron length of the teeth. Okay, so this is the formula for the finding the width of the stator teeth. Now stator core design, the design or the depth of the stator core usually depends upon the flux density, okay, and which is around, or its range is given from 1.2 to 1.5 Weber per meter square. Now from the total flux in the air gap, the flux passing through the stator core is half of the flux per pole, so it is given by phi m by 2, because this is the flux passing through the air gap or the flux per pole. Now the flux in the stator core is half the flux per pole. Okay, now the flux density in the stator core is given by BCS. The area of the stator core is equal to flux through core, that is phi m by 2, and the flux density in the core is given by BCS. How we are getting this equation, we are quite clear, that flux density is given by flux upon area. Now we are finding area, so we will be getting flux upon flux density, we will be getting an area. So here we are getting the equation. Now also the area of the stator core, area of the stator core is given by length into depth. Now length we have already seen, length of the ion is given by Li and depth is DCS. Here in this diagram you can easily see that this is DCS, this portion is DCS, right? So DCS, so we are getting the area of the stator core. So here we are getting two equations for the area of the stator core. One is this and one is this. So we can equate both these equations. So Li into DCS is equal to phi m upon 2BCS, right? Now, when we equate this DCS, we are taking Li on the other side, we get the equation DCS is equal to phi m upon 2BCS into Li, right? So this we are getting the depth of the core. Now the outer diameter of the stator core, we are talking about this portion, outer diameter of the stator core, this entire part we are talking about, it is nothing but the capital D. It is denoted by D0. Now what is D? D is this much portion, the outer diameter is denoted by D. This is D0, this is D, okay? So we are getting D0 is equal to D plus 2 into depth of the stator core and depth of the stator slots and depth of the core. So when we put these values, we get an equation D0, outer diameter of the stator core, as D is equal to 2DSS plus 2DCS, okay? So here we have finished the design of the stator part. Now in next lecture we will be seeing few of the numericals based on the design of the stator, and then we will be moving on to the design of the rotor part, okay?